Salem to Yahweh, beloved brothers and sisters. Good morning. I have a vision last night that I'm cleaning a dirty room scattered by many dirt and branches of cut trees and plants around the corner. And I clean it. And I wonder what is that dream, that vision. And I remember when Mulkiyoli Yahushua said, I came not to destroy or abolish the law, but I came to fulfill them, establish and fulfill them. So there's no law being destroyed or removed by Almighty Creator through our Mulkiyoli Yahushua. But it came, Mulkiyoli Yahushua came to establish and fulfill them. So my beloved brother, don't use that syllogism or preposition to break the law. Because almost I've seen in the comments of many religions that it was already nailed in the post, all the laws. That's why they are not obeying the law, because no more law. They break all the law because their understanding is very null and void, their understanding. The beloved brothers and sisters, be aware by these false doctrines, many false teachers, false prophet, a false priest telling you that no more law, because it was already nailed in the house of Mulkiyoli Yahushua. Mulkiyoli Yahushua retreated. I came not to destroy the law or abolish them, but to fulfill and establish them. Always remember that, because it was said, many come in my name, saying, Master, Master, we came in your name, and we have reputed by the Spirit. We have made wonder by your name. But Mulkiyoli also said, get away from me, I don't know you. Why? Because he used the name of Mulkiyoli Yahushua as your reason to break the law and to reason out your perverted for your own righteousness. They pervert the law because their own righteousness. To beloved brother and sister, be aware that many coming in the name of Mulkiyoli Yahushua, but for their own righteousness, as stated, reiterated by Mulkiyoli Yahushua, I came not to destroy the law or abolish them, but I came to establish and fulfill them. Did you see anything that Mulkiyoli was violated? Nothing. I just explain the proper understanding. Because the law of faith is love and fearing Yahweh, as like Abraham. He was called righteous in front of Yahweh because of fearing and loving Yahweh. That is the definition of faith. the proper definition of faith. If you are faithful to our Almighty Creator, you must love Him in faith and obey all His commandments. Only the blood of mortal Yahushua, which is blotted out, is the handwriting and ordinances which are written by the Pharisee. If blotted out, the handwritings and ordinance which is written by the Pharisee by their own righteousness. So remember that. Don't use the parable like the parable or the vision of one apostle or disciple of Mortal Yahushua, that the dreams that many dirty creatures he was seeing in his vision, that it was commanded to him to eat. But I cannot eat that because that is dirty. But the Almighty Creator said, you can eat because I've already cleaned them. That is a vision regarding a people like Cornelius. Cornelius was considered as a dirty animal, creatures, because they are pagan. But it was cleaned by Almighty Creator, because by faith, and it was understood by that disciple, that the vision that they have seen is, it was Cornelius, like a dirty creatures, and it was cleaned by Almighty Creator, and they were baptized, because it was commanded by vision to baptize these people, Cornelius. But has Satan used that as a precedent of their argument? Oh, no more laws, because it was dream to the apostle that all dirty creatures been cleaned by the Almighty Creator, so you can eat them all. Eat the pig, eat the snake, all the kind of creatures you can eat, because it was dream and it was clean. No, that is a wrong interpretation given you by Satan. Christ Satan make you. That's why it was called Christ Satan, a crying Satan. To believe on him, so we made this name Christ Satan, crying Satan. And it was a masquerade like angel, a Moloch. Christ Satan. Oh, no more dirty animals. We can eat all the snake, even the lizard, even what kind of that you can use as food that already clean. That is a syllogism or preposition used by Christ Satan to make you dirty, because Almighty Creator said, did I create the world and heaven, and my footstool is the earth, and my pillow is in heaven. So, how could Almighty Creator stay of man-made buildings? He does not stay on man-made buildings, because the footstool of Almighty Creator is the earth, and His pillow is in heaven. What is the temple of Almighty Creator? It's your vessel. So clean thy vessel, clean your body, so that the Almighty Creator, the Spirit of Yahweh, Him Kabuha be with you. How to be clean? It was written in the Leviticus chapter 11, the clean food and unclean animals. Animals in the very beginning, Adam and Kaba never ate animals. They eat only fruits and vegetables. But because in the time of Noah, in the flood, that's why we are permitted to eat living animals. As long the blood is being poured out in the earth or the soil, because blood is the water of life. So we should not eat it. But in Leviticus chapter 11, it distinguished there the clean animal and dirty animal. Because Almighty Creator created a dirty animal and created clean animal. And this clean animal, you have the right to eat, but you have to pour out this blood in soil, because that is significant of life. Because our mortal Yahushua, he pour out this blood in the ground, shredded in the ground, to wash our sin from the beginning that we have inherited. We are redeemed from the bondage of sin by His blood. That's why that is the symbolism of blood. So the blood is being poured out in the ground because that is symbolizing life. But the crying Satan, or cry Satan, saying, "Oh, no more law, you can eat all, even the blood." That's why they are making we put that pool of blood. They call it dinner daraan in Filipino. They are foolish people because they are blinded by their false teachers, false pastor. There's no law being abolished. Only the handwriting ordinance been written by the Pharisee been blotted out, and they sacrifice animal sacrifice, because what is the use of animal sacrifice? Already is superseded by the greater blood of Molkir Yahushua. Molkir Yahushua is the eternal sacrifice. His blood, it is the living lamb sacrifice. Well, now, what is the use of sacrificing animals if our old man or our Molkir Yahushua is already the sacrifice for us from the bondage of sin? That is the one which has been superseded or abolished. Why? Because if you are poor, you cannot sacrifice a bullock to be, your life been forgiven, your sin been forgiven. But the blood of Molkir Yahushua, even what is your nationality, as long that you believe in the Dam Gam Suam of Molkir Yahushua and been baptized through our through our Almighty Creator, from the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit, or the Abiol, the Baruch Kayai, and the Ruach HaYeshua, and you mean saved. So you must be wise, as the Ruach HaYeshua Kokmaul, to make you understand and perceive the right and wrong, and good should be done and evil should avoid it. Don't be deceived by the flatteries of this strong delusion spoken in the book of Daniel. The rap god, who is this rap god? It was Sius Dios, Iasus Christus, the rap god of Grecia, the idol of Greek Egyptian Serapis Christus, disciple and prophets and false teacher. They are the one who saying no more law. They are lawless people because they are disciples of crying Satan. So, beloved brother, remember, since my very beginning, since 1972. My grand lolo gave me a Bible, he gave King James Version, and I read that Genesis to Revelation. And the brother of my grand lolo of mother side, Lolo Marcelo, give me a China Bible version, Assembly of Yahweh. I read it also, Genesis to Revelation. Took me 1 year, more than 1 year to read it. That's why I have researched more the name, and I found it, the name of Yahweh. It was written in the forehead of the people in the East, because their favorite word is Yao. Dayao sa Ilocano. Dayao means honor, worship, prestige, respect. That is the definition of Dayao, the knowledge of Yao. So, remember that the name of Almighty Creator is written in our forehead. Oh, it was written also in the prophecy. Zechariah 8:7. I will gather all my children from the east, from the west. And also, Yahushua chapter 43 verse 5, because Almighty Creator promised that He will gather His Son from the east and west. So, remember, how could you be saved if you are breaking the law? Because the heresy given by you by the Christ Satan Passator, who is Passator, the disciple of Rukut Harod Mehasatan. So, you must pray to Almighty Creator. Yaholim Kabuha, I give His Ruka Hutsuwa Kukmaol through the name of Mulkil Yahushul Meskai. That will guide you to understand the truth that lead you to the eternal life, so that you can enter the gate of the city they have prepared and eat the fruit of the tree of life. Now, how could you eat that if you are believing the heresy of the Christ Satan's disciples, that no more law, and we already nailed in the post, so they can eat everything because everything is clean for them? Our Almighty Creator created everything, the dirt, the unclean and clean. So, because your body is the vessel of Yahweh, it is the temple of Yahweh. So, clean your vessel, because if you are clean, the Almighty Creator, Spirit Aruka of Yahweh will stay on you. And the robot around, or the body spirit, cannot enter your body, because you don't give it any way that it can enter your body, because it was clean and guided by the Ruach HaKodesh. So remember, there's no been abolished by Almighty Creator, because what is stated by Mulkil Yahushua, I came not to destroy or abolish the law, but I came to establish and fulfill them, and He fulfilled it. So, what is written in the Leviticus, that was not abolished. The unclean is still unclean, and the clean is still clean. So remember that. These people who are telling you, the Christ Satan disciple, the unclean become already clean. So there's no unclean to them, because they are deceived by strong delusion, the abominable dissolution, the idol of abominable dissolution. So be wise, because it was written. Get away from me. I don't know you, because you violated the law. That's why I don't know you. How could you say that you are in faith when the law will hurt you? A faith is a new faith, a new covenant. It's the same as old, but the only difference is that it was written in your mind, in your heart. That is the new covenant. It was written in our mind by Almighty Creator and our heart. Now, how could you now differentiate unclean and clean matters? Because it was already written in your mind, like a computer. It is already put in the disk of your mind, the computer. Do you know computer? This a chip put in the computer. The storage chip. So if you are put in there, all what is your recorder there been seen in your computer. That is the law of the new covenant, been written and already put in your mind, in your heart. So beloved brother and sister, always remember, the old and new covenant is the same, but the different only, the new covenant is written in your mind, in your heart. Because all the books, almost all the books that copied by the crying Satan, been corrupted. The first was correct. First corruption is they changed the name Almighty Creator, Yahweh Gabua. It was written in four letter, which vocalized Yahweh, and was written in the Hebrew scripture 6973 plus, but it was all erased and put their idol. What is their idol? What is the idol of Christ Satan? It was Deus, God, Lord, Jehovah, Jesus, Christus. All this volume, what is stated in the Mulyaol or the in the Holy Hebrew or Holy Scripture, what is written there? Nothing been changed. Don't call the name of Balaam. Balaam. What is Balaam? The idols. The name or the master of all nations. The idol of nation are Balaam. Baal means the master. Baal is God, Lord, Deus, Dios, Jesus. All that's Baal. Allah, that is Baal. That is why he reiterated to Joshua and told them the first time that he told his name is in Horeb. And the last is in the Mount Sinai. It was written in the Ten Commandments, number 3. Now, what is the first that violated by Christ Satan, crying Satan? They changed the name of Almighty Creator. The number 3 of the Ten Commandments, there is it. They put the name of Nimrod idol, God, the skull idol, God, the third angel of Hasatan, God, Gadril. How foolishness. They said, oh, we cannot understand the name of Yahuwah because that is given to Yahudim or Hebrew people. So, I understand the Babylonian idol God. So, we are the generation of, spiritually generation of Nimrod, who erected the Tower of Babel. Now, you call your Bible, your book is Bible, the Tower of Spirit of Rokot Haraot. Bible is the Tower of Rokot Haraot. Why? When Nimrod erected the Tower of Babel, but now the Nimrodim, the descendant of Nimrodim, spirit is Bible. They copy the Torah, the Tanakh, or Moliaol, the books which are dictated by Almighty Creator to His prophet. But they name it Bible, Bible, the books of demonology. So, beloved brothers and sisters, that's why the Almighty Creator said, I will give them new covenant. What is the new covenant? The new covenant and the old is the same. But its only difference is it was written in their mind, in their heart. So, if it was written in your mind, in love, in fearing Yahuwah, you should not be corrupted by the lies and flatteries of the abominable desolation that lead you to the pit of perdition in the lake of brimstone, in fire and Sheol. Salam to Yahud, Imkanam Biyoskai, Ruka, Yahushua, Olsuam Golmurul Ramauru Reepul Moseo, Yahushua Olmiskai, Amin Amun. Hallelujah, Hallelujah, Jabul Yagabur, Amayagana Samuja, Udayawa, Amin Amun. Thank you.